Hi everyone, we are Joy.Refill.
I am Charlotte.
I'm Charmaine.
Welcome to our second Join.R interview episode. Today, our main focus will be academic pressure.
So as mentioned in the first episode before, we have been collecting you guys' responses and questions about mental health. And we are very honored to invite Ms Yama Yeung, a social worker from HKUGA College, and she will be answering all our questions and giving us professional advice.
This interview will be conducted in Cantonese, but don't worry, we'll be adding English subtitles later on.
Enjoy!
好，咁我哋而家就開始個訪問啦。OK，Ms Yeung，第一條問題就係咧，有邊啲跡象就係代表我哋壓力過大咧？咁啊，而家咧我顯示咗一幅圖啦，咁係講緊我哋嘅壓力同埋我哋個表現之間嘅關係嘅。咁啊，你見到啦，如果我哋壓力細嘅時候咧，我哋相對個情緒都會平靜啲嘅。咁去到中間嗰個部分咧，就係我哋個表現同埋壓力咧，都係比較好嘅，最高嘅嗰個點啦。咁呢個期間都係一個良性嘅壓力嚟嘅。咁但係去到一啲嘅臨界點咧，就係你壓力太大啦。咁你開始你個表現 下跌咧，嗰啲就係你一啲嘅惡性嘅壓力。咁而表徵上面，我哋點可以睇到我哋係有壓力咧？可以從幾方面去睇到嘅。咁啊，第一樣啦，就係喺你哋嘅行為上面啦。咁啊，會容易啲暴躁啊，或者你會容易啲可能瞓唔著啊，食嘢食得唔好啊，咁呢啲狀況就喺行為上面會見到。咁喺心理上面咧，都會見到嘅喎。有啲同學會容易啲頭痛啦、胃痛啦，咁會有呢啲生理反應話俾你聽，其實你已經壓力太大啦。
咁啊，仲有咧就係你哋嘅情緒啦，就話講咗容易啲暴躁嘅，可能亦都會容易啲唔開心嘅。咁啊，好波動嘅狀態啦。咁啊，同埋最後仲有一樣就係記憶力喺你哋認知上面啦。咁啊，可能記憶力會容易啲差啲啦，未必記得到咁多嘢啦，都有呢啲狀況係可以留意得到嘅。
嗯，好。咁我哋喺我第二條問題啦，就係咧，有啲同學咧佢好努力去温書啦，但佢個成績都不如理想咁樣嘅。
咁佢就覺得自己好一無是處啦，甚至有時好爭自己喎。咁佢有咩可以做去解決呢個問題呢？嗯，嗱呢個咧都好普遍好多年青人都有嘅狀況，因為咧我哋好容易因為社會環境啦或者身邊啲朋友啊屋企人啊，我哋都會當咗呢個學業咧係唯一一個標準去判斷自己嘅嗰個能力啦。咁啊，其實實際上唔係噶嘛，我哋有好多方面都可以判斷一個人嘅一啲能力啦，佢嘅表現啦，即係例如你哋嘅人際關係啊，你哋嘅可能一啲特質。 可能係你個人係比較和善嘅，容易啲同人相處嘅，又或者可能唔係叻喺呢一度，可能係學術啊，或者可能係喺一啲運動啊、藝術方面嘅，都係可以用其他嘅標準去衡量咯，唔好將學業咧變成唯一嘅標準。好，唔該。
So now we're going to play a game called What to Do. First, one of us will read a situation raised by you guys. Then we will have 30 seconds to write down ways to solve this situation on our whiteboards. Then after 30 seconds, both of us will share our answers first and ask Ms. Yama Yeung for suggestions. And last, Ms. Yama Yeung will share her answer and elaborate on it.
好，咁我哋而家咧就開始講第一個情景啦。咁呢位同學咧就話佢喺呢個長假期入邊咧，佢好盡力咁去盡快完成佢嘅功課啦，同埋温習咁樣。但佢又發現咧，自己好似冇乜動力咁，有時佢寧願瞓覺都唔做温書啦。咁佢就覺得好影響佢心理健康，令到佢好擔心自己嘅成績咁樣。咁佢每一次唔想温書咧，都覺得好大壓力，唔知應該點做啦。咁即管佢用咗好多方法去推動自己去努力啲去温書啦，但佢都實現唔到佢嘅目標。咁佢就好想趁 未翻face to face之前呢段時間咧，就可以去揾到自己嘅目標啦，同埋多翻啲動力，同埋解決呢個拖延症嘅問題。嗯，好，咁我哋30秒。好，咁我講先啦。咁我咧呢個答案就係定可行嘅目標啦，同埋當自己完成咗一個短期嘅目標之後咧，就要記得好多啲去稱讚自己咁樣咯。咁Ms Yeung，你覺得點？
呢個係一個好好嘅方法嚟嘅，因為咧即係對於一啲如果拖延症嘅同學係佢冇一啲目標啦，或者個目標原來唔係好具體，唔係好可行嘅話咧，係會令到佢更加唔想做嘅。咁所以一定要定一啲咧係真係可行嘅具體嘅目標，同埋做好咗之後咧都獎勵自己啦，稱讚自己啦，咁啊令到自己快啲嘅動力嘅。
嗯，好，跟住就到我嘅答案啦。咁我嘅答案咧就係當發現自己可能做緊一樣唔想做嘅嘢嘅時候，就發覺自己完全做唔到落去，即係 集中唔到啊，同埋諗唔到應該做咩嘅時候，就應該係停止手頭上所有嘅工作，而係去休息咁樣。
咁啊，呢個都係誒類似正話嘅同學一齊講嘅嗰樣嘢啦。其實咧，當自己真係諗唔到自己嘅方向嘅時候咧，可能未必有一個好好嘅目標或者方向。咁俾自己停低諗清楚先去做咧，都係一個好嘅方法嚟嘅。
同意㗎。
我哋睇下Ms Yeung你嘅答案。
好，咁啊，我咧其實寫咗啲咩咧？咁我就寫咗，其實咧拖延症咧，其實原來有好多唔同嘅因素會有呢一樣嘅狀況出現嘅。咁啊，例如咧，第一可能同學仔覺得嗰樣嘢咧根本就唔重要，唔緊急嘅，咁你自然你就會拖啦，唔會去做啦。第二咧就係有啲人咧就會係唔知點樣踏出第一步啊，你唔行第一步嘅時候，自然嗰樣嘢就唔會開始，唔會做得到
我覺得不好的時候，唔能夠做到最 perfect，佢可能會選擇唔開始或者唔做。亦都有啲同學咧就係一啲 deadline fighter，我覺得越遲做，去到咧 deadline 啊先做咧，咁所以咪一路拖咯，拖到最後一秒咁樣，或者咧亦都有啲同學咧係可能好多誘惑啦，或者相對比較懶惰嘅情況。咁點解會寫呢個出嚟呢？因為要睇翻究竟係咩原因去令到你會有呢一個可能冇動力嘅情況啦，會導致你就係所講嘅拖延症啦。咁我哋就會針對翻唔同嘅情況咧，而去揾一啲合適嘅方法嘅。
好似正話講嘅，例如可能佢嗰個目標原來唔係好合適，咁就要揾翻啲合適嘅方法啦。如果可能佢個時間管理得唔好嘅，要諗一啲方法係啱佢嘅時間管理啦。咁如果佢係一個好完美主義嘅同學嘅話咧，咁佢可能要調節一下可能佢自己嘅期望啦。咁所以咧，針對唔同嘅情況咧，都有唔同嘅解決方法嘅。
嗯，好。
咁我哋而家就開始第一題啦。咁第二題咧，呢位同學咧就話咧，佢喺學校就覺得好迷茫啦，就唔知揀咩科同埋好冇方向。 咁但係佢又見到好多friend咧，自己啲朋友咧又好有目標啊，好有方向咁，但係就係得自己冇。咁佢就想問下，應該點樣去調整呢個心態，同埋點樣去 set
好，咁我而家就睇下我嘅答案啦。我嘅答案咧就係排除法啦。咁咧就諗住咧將同學嘅一啲佢好中意嘅科啦，同埋佢做得好好嘅科，同埋佢好唔中意嘅科咧就分咗三類啦。咁佢就可以用以啲知道自己邊啲係佢比較中意，但係都係成績比較做得好嘅一啲科目咁。
嗯，咁呢個方法都係其中一種可行嘅方法嚟嘅。當你乜都唔知，用咩方向去揀嘅時候，咁係可能按自己嘅興趣啊，按自己嘅能力咧去做一啲嘅排除法，去揀選篩選一個可能合適佢嘅科目咯。
嗯，好。 好，跟住就到我嘅答案啦。我嘅答案咧就首先咧唔好同人比較啦，因為頭先嗰個 case 就係講個人會同啲 friend 比較啦。咁呢個就唔好做啦。跟住下面咧要點樣選科目咧，就係應該係選自己中意嘅科目先嘅。咁呢個係行喺第一位啦。但係咧，如果你話你任何一科你都好唔中意咁樣，咁就揀啲遲啲出到社會咧係容易賺勁多錢嗰啲科目，咁就係咯，就係咁簡單。你有咩睇法？
OK，都係某一啲都係一個可以取態嚟嘅，係一個揀選你自己心目中嘅科目啦，揀喜歡嘅。咁亦都有啲人都會揀嗰個前途有關嘅相關嘅科目都可行嘅。咁所以不過除咗呢啲以外咧，我覺得仲有其他嘅因素可以考慮咯。
嗯，好。
咁所以就睇下我嘅答案啦。咁啊，我咧都同鄭華同埋一樣啦。咁啊，首先唔好比較啦，就按翻自己嘅步伐同埋個需要咧去做一啲選擇嘅。 因為咧，我上一集都有講過啦，青年人喺呢段時間都係揾緊一個自我認同嘅時候，咁每個人嗰個成長嘅一個步伐係唔一樣嘅，有啲人快啲，有啲人慢啲，咁所以咧唔好同其他人比較，而目標咧其實中間都可以有一啲嘅變化嘅咁樣。咁如果我哋真係揀科咧，我覺得可以有幾個方面可以去揀，第一咧就係按自己嘅一啲興趣啦，咁啊亦都睇自己嘅能力啦。 另外咧，聽下人哋嘅意見，例如朋友啦、屋企人啦，咁其實佢哋會唔會有啲嘅期望或者諗法，都可以考慮佢哋嘅一啲意見嘅。另外咧，亦都好似正話所講，會唔會喺嗰個社會嘅環境啊、前途啊，同埋自己嘅夢想上面咧，都可以考慮埋呢啲嘅因素先去做一啲嘅考慮同揀選咯。 咁啊，喺目標方面咧，咁啊就盡量要揀一啲係大家可行嘅具體嘅目標去定。咁唔一定咧好遠大，我已經諗住做醫生咁樣，就呢個係可能係一個有啲同學仔嘅夢想。但係咧，我哋可以細步啲，做醫生之前其實仲有好多嘅步驟噶嘛，可以咧細到簡單嘅係今次個考試嗰個成績啦，或者可能。 唔單止定嗰個目標係成績學業，好似我就開頭講，好多時我哋壓力咧，淨係因為 focus 咗喺我哋學業嗰度，其實咧我哋仲可以睇埋個目標可以定立喺你嘅人際關係啊、你嘅日常生活嘅作息啊、你嘅興趣啊，唔同方面其實都可以定一啲嘅目標嘅。
好，咁我哋今日嘅訪問咧就嚟到呢度啦。咁真係好多謝 Ms Yama Yeung， 佢肯抽時間喺疫情都陪我哋做訪問啦。
This is the end of our video. So feel free to ask us anything if you want. Do comment, like, and share if you like this video. See you soon. Bye. Bye.